most famous building in this area, in this part of town, and even with new high-rise building around, you will see this tower from all south of Moscow. And yes, we have only six section tower, but originally, you know, it was planned to build it nine section and about 350 meters. And it's 30 meters over the height of Eiffel Tower in Paris. And also they use one third of material because of modern invention of construction, and it's a Shukhov invention, construction with very economical use of
steel grid cell.
Steel, yes, it's a steel grid, and Shukhov have patents for this type of constructions, not only for towers, but different shapes of roofs. For example, he used in the Melnikov gardens, and also many other buildings. We have over 40 buildings in Moscow with participation of Shukhov as engineer, but only one now with Shukhov is as architect. We have a few towers similar but smaller around the Russia, maybe closer to Moscow. It's in the small city called Lobnia, it's near Sheremetyevo Airport. But of course, we have also different towns, and also we have in Polipino the first one tower originally built in Nizhny Novgorod for Nizhny Novgorod Fair 1885 as observation tower, and this type of construction used now, for example, for high-rise buildings, for example, for 600 meter high skyscraper in China. And yes. Now access to this area is forbidden for visitors because they have some TV center here and some part of space communication agency on the staff. Only few people know the hole in the fence on the backside. And they crawl during night time and make some pictures inside, but now close it. As they say, it's because the dangerous situation is construction, but they don't do anything to solve it because, of course, needed some political will and some funding. Original project, yes. No, original project was nine sections and 350 meters. But it's built only six sections, 150.
But it's twice higher than Ivan the Great's tower in Kremlin.
Tower, yes.
And it was a law in Russia for many, many centuries not to build something higher than Ivan the Great.
Yes.
Like so it was a revolution.
They had St. Peter's, and they just built two towers in the south EUR area, and they are the same height.
Речная оболочка. Это патентованная конструкция Шухова. Норман Фостер третью часть своих всех сооружений делает на базе сетчатой оболочки Шухова. У Нормана Фостера целый отдел, который занимается изучением шуховского наследия. Поэтому как бы вот эта конструкция, она живет в 21 веке. В русской архитектуре не тиражируются ни одни сооружения русских архитекторов по всему миру, так как сооружение Шухова. В устье Днепра, под Херсоном, там стоит 70-метровый маяк от Жигульского. Ему 100 лет в этом году исполнилось. Татлин, он был моряком, он плавал мимо этого маяка, и он видел конструкции внутри, потому что башня Татлина – это фактически модификация от Жигульского маяка, который еще раньше был сделан. Поэтому весь конструктивизм фактически вот с башни Татлина
начинается.
Да,
виду вот эту,
да, вот это именно. Это, она похожа на Жигульский маяк. То есть Татлин ничего нового не придумал, он просто копировал идеи Шухова.
А что там, такая штука?